Okay, I'm back in the car and I'm getting ready to pull out of Days Inn. The clerk here, Jay, very sweet woman, and I said goodbye to her, and I may be back down through here to spend a day and a half to check out the scenery, because this is really a cool town, Fort Smith. I knew nothing about it before, but I'm hoping I'll get to see more on my way back, if I possibly can, after coming through Memphis. All right, we're going to drive through town and get a little bit of look at the sights during the day, and then head out and northeast up towards St. Louis, and then heading towards Michigan from there. Okay, we're going to go through the downtown area and then make some detours, but there's a University of Arkansas, Fort Smith is down here as well. And there looks like there's some great places to eat, and good places to shop down here. It's definitely an older downtown district, but it also looks like it's thriving as well. It does not look dead like so many of the other towns that I've been in. But it's also right near, or right on the Arkansas River. So we've got a definitely lively downtown area that I came through. And I think we're gonna be going over the Arkansas River after we get through these lights, and then back up to the 40. There's definitely a lot of old architecture here. I'm not sure what that, the remains of that building is, but it says Reynolds, Davis & Company. That looks like a beautiful park. Okay, we're going up over the river, and I'll get a shot of that as we go through. It looks like a lovely park right there along the riverbank. Part of the Arkansas River. I'll show you the other side. Here we go. We're going to come back here, I think, to Fort Smith and get a better look at all of the scenery that they have. It's a big river, the Arkansas River. Unfortunately, due to the time constraints, I didn't make it back to Fort Smith or the Arkansas River or the park by the Arkansas River, but I do like to say this, or I would like to say this. I guess I gotta watch out for my language. I would like to say that if you have an opportunity to go down to Fort Smith and to spend some time at the Arkansas River, it's actually a very beautiful area, and I highly recommend it. Remember, you can do that through one website, and we give it to you free. Just go there and do your booking. TheMaverickExperience.com. We're waiting for you. There's a nice view of some very lush mountain ranges. We are going north on the I-540 towards Fayetteville. Woo. That is one lush mountain range. Fayetteville. Again, beautiful mountain scenery here. Going through another tunnel here, the Bobby Hopper Tunnel. Bobby Hopper Tunnel here on the I-540. And here we go through. And on the other side will be Fayetteville. They've got big fans in here, of course, to blow the exhaust through because it's a fairly large tunnel. We're coming out on the other side.
Woo!
Okay, we went through that mountain. See you in Fayetteville. They have a Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard here in Fayetteville. I thought that was appropriate to pay a little lacage au full, since Fayetteville is relatively a French-sounding word. And there's a lot of Creole people that live in Arkansas, probably more southern part of Arkansas. Anyway, we're going to have to get gas, so we're going to be doing that right now, pulling off of the freeway and try and find a place to get some gas. Maybe we can see Fayetteville off in the distance. I'm not sure. We could see it when we were coming in. I don't know if we can see it now. I guess not. All right. So I'm not the world's greatest lip syncer, but I was entertaining myself. We're talking about 16-hour days driving by myself, and I got bored. So please, don't fault me for my, what do you want to call it, my crude form of entertainment. But really it was for me more than it was for you. However, I chose to share it with you. Remember, don't just have a good time, have a good stupid time, and enjoy yourself when you take these trips across the country. And remember, I will be there following you all the way, just like you're following me, because I know you're going to be using my website to book those hotels if you're driving, or your airfare and car rentals, or anything else you need, because that's what this is all about, to get you to believe you can have a great time and use a fantastic website like www.themaverickexperience.com to get you there. So whether or not I'm a great lip syncer, please don't fault my website, because it's actually spot on. Okay, we're going to stop here at the Shepherd Hills Factory Outlet Mall just for a minute. So I'm going to show the outside, and then I'm going to go inside and take a look around, and hopefully my bicycle will still be on the back when I come out. But I've got it locked up. But I thought it'd be a nice little stop for me and see what they have in this little outlet mall here in Missouri. All right. Found it. There it is. Route 66 rocker. The world's largest rocker. The giant rocker. Now I have to find the world's largest frying pan. And we're going to go into the general store here. This is the general store right outside the world's giant rocker. And I'm going to show you the front. There we go. Here's the Fanning Outpost General Store on Missouri's US Route 66. And if I pan over, you'll see my Durango. And then you'll see how big that rocker is compared to my Durango down there. It's huge, people. So there you have it. We found in Missouri, off of the 44, the world's largest rocker. And we'll go into the store in just a second. It's going to be a lot of fun. Yes! What's your name? And here we are inside the Route 66 Fanning Outpost, and this is
Jackie Sansone.
Jackie, and Jackie knows all about that sign too. She knows that drags people in off of the freeway.
Absolutely.
This is a really cool looking store too.
You haven't gotten through half of it.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep going. So just remember, everybody, you can't get here by flying. You gotta drive. You can only fly once you get here, and that's usually a drink. So they have an indoor range here. You can see, so you can get your crossbow right at the desk here, at the counter, and then you can go right back over here and shoot at the range. Okay, we're back inside the storefront area. It's a lot of fun here. We're gonna pick up a couple of souvenirs too while we're in here. Might as well. They drew me in, I might as well shop a little bit. And this is off of exit 203, correct? 203 is the exit off of the 44, correct?
Correct.
And we are in Fanning, Missouri.
Yes.
Fanning, Missouri.
It's the Highway F exit.
Highway F exit?
Yep.
Okay, turn around to me for just a second. Highway F exit, don't forget that, friends and family, because you know this is being brought to you by what? TheMaverickExperience.com. See you later. I'm going to go have a glass of wine.
Okay, the wine sample I'm drinking is right here, the Missouri Root Red, and it's a semi-sweet wine, and you can get it right here.
And only here.
And only here at right there on her shirt, the Fanning US 66 Outpost, and you see right there, Cuba, Missouri, and there's the phone number in case you need it. You can always order it from them directly.
Yep.
But this is the bathroom in the Fanning Route 66 store. This is the men's bathroom. It is so quaint and awesome. I'll back up so you can see. I'm not kidding. And it's as clean can be. Amazing. Okay, everybody. Well, that was a fun little stop, even though I'm not going to make it very far tonight, but that was a fun little stop into the Fanning Outpost General Store, and you can see the world's largest rocker behind me, and Jackie was so wonderful. She was amazing. So when you come out here down 44, you've got to exit 203, and then you have to go right off the exit 203, and then you have to go immediately left about 3 miles down the road, and you will find the Route 66 merchant store here, and ask for Jackie. She was fabulous. She's a sweetheart. And the wine, oh, I bought a bottle of wine that's made right here in the Fanning area. You'll love it. All right, guys, we're on to St. Louis. So you know, we left that wonderful store, and we are actually traveling down part of what's left of the old Route 66. There's farms along here, and there's cows, there's railroad tracks over to the right. And so, believe me, some of the historic Route 66 still exist, and it's worth an opportunity to take a look off of the main highway. We're still off of Route 66, we're coming into a little town called Cuba, and I hear they have some murals around town, so we're gonna see if we can find a couple of the murals before we head back up onto the main drag. But I guess it is a quaint little town. Okay, guys, here we are. We are in downtown Cuba, Missouri. And it's a quaint little town, some historic buildings. And over here is one of the murals. And we're just gonna go through the town here real slow so that you can see it, and we'll turn back up the other way, and I know there's another mural, so we're gonna stop at the main street here. There's some more murals. Battle of Pilot Knob, it says. There's a bit of a glare. Let me see if I can get that better for you. Major General Sterling Price and Brigadier General Thomas Ewing, Jr. And here's some more murals coming up. We're just gonna go slow because I do wanna get past St. Louis. And these are the murals, again, on Missouri's Route 66 here in Cuba. There's another mural coming up. I'm gonna pull back a little bit, so hopefully you can see that one as well. People's Bank, there you go. There's another mural painted on this wall right here. Classic cars right here, parking right along here. And we have the Wagon Wheel Motel. Wagon Wheel Motel. We have Missouri Hick Barbecue here. Obviously, Missouri Hick Barbecue is very popular, not for vegetarians though. It's not for vegetarians, but here we are in Cuba. Just a quick note for you. There really wasn't that much to see after I left Cuba, Missouri, and headed to Ratul, Illinois. But I did have a good time, and again, I enjoyed my lip-syncing immensely. But there wasn't a lot to see, and I think the battery was going low on the camera, so we got a short gap there. But you get the point, and there's still plenty out there between those two cities. You just have to explore it for yourself. Okay, people, this is where I stopped for the night. This is downtown Ratul, Illinois. It's a tiny, sleepy little town. Definitely an older community. And They have tiny little stores, and there's not a lot here, but we're gonna go down through town here. I stopped at the Ratul Motel. It's a quaint little place to do a film. If you wanted to do a film about a real small town, this would be a place to film. You could probably get it cheap. And we're still in Ratul. We're just going down Champagne Boulevard, looking at some of the older homes in the area that are on the boulevard. Here comes a really nice one up here, big kind of antebellum home. We are still outside of Ratul, where I stopped in last night, and there is corn as far as the eye can see just outside of town here. And it's pretty amazing, all these cornfields. And if you just drive down this road here, you'll see it's corn, and more corn. It's pretty cool. And this, like I said, is just outside of Ratul going west, just before the freeway.
Well, they do have a Walmart Supercenter here,
and we're going to stop into Walmart Supercenter and get some fresh fruit. Okay, so I'm going to go in here into the Ratul Walmart Supercenter and pick me up some fresh fruit and some water, some stuff to nosh on, because I'm on to Michigan City from here, and then I'll be going across the 94 into Michigan. And that should take me about 3 hours or so, with a stop in Michigan City. And they don't let you film anything inside there, so I can't take the camera in with me. So I'll leave it here and I'll talk to you later.
Now, one of the things you may not know about me is that I love making healthy, fresh smoothies. This one, I know it looks pretty nasty because it's green, but on the road, I made my own. I took my Vitamix or blender with me, and I took a lot of things that I could take with me, walnuts and cashews and things like that were raw, and then I would pick up my fresh fruits and vegetables on the road, just like I did at Walmart. And that was a nice thing, that Walmart was almost anywhere I went. And now I know some people don't appreciate and like Walmart, but you've got to admit, you can get just about anything you need at a super Walmart. And the one thing about Ratul, there may not have been a lot of things there, but right off the freeway entrance, right there just outside of Ratul, was Walmart. And I picked up a few more things to make myself a fresh smoothie. This green smoothie, maybe later on I'll talk about exactly what I put in it. But I'm just enjoying this right now as I explain to you my journey. Drink up.
What does it mean to travel all the way across the country, hopefully gaining support for themaverickexperience.com? Simply this, is that when you travel the country and you go to different places, you experience a level of abundance that you may not realize existed. And it is there for all of us to appreciate and enjoy, including the police officer that's trying to catch people speeding along the freeway that I just passed. I'm going to show you what I mean by level of abundance just by turning this camera around and letting you know that there's plenty for all of us. It's just we need to ask the universe for our fair share, and then we need to believe we can have it. I'm going to turn the camera around and I'm going to show you what I mean. Alright, so look at what there is. Land and more land abundant. And in this land, just here alone, that you can see through my dirty windshields, is corn. Hundreds and thousands of acres of corn and farmland. And in the heartland of the country, and in many other areas of the country, we have people that are helping us achieve that level of abundance in our lives. And that means food for everybody to share. Everyone can have a piece of the pie if we just believe that we deserve it and claim it. Name it and claim it is the old saying. And part of what I believe is that we get greedy and we get selfish when we believe there's not enough for all of us. But there is plenty for all of us if we start feeding it to one another instead of feeding it to livestock. We'll save a lot more money that way, and we'll save a lot more lives. And maybe I'm harping and preaching at the moment, but it's about that. It's about taking and believing that we have a level of abundance. There's a lot of alfalfa right there. So there you go. Look at that. Just fields and fields and fields of grain, excuse me, corn along this pathway on the I-57 inside of Illinois. We can all then share in the level of abundance of whatever it is we want to do with our life. We can travel. We can vacation. We can book hotels. We can rent cars. We can do all the things we put our minds to that we want to do to enjoy and experience life. And that's why I call it the Maverick Experience, because we all have our own individual experiences which make us a maverick when we choose to do it our way, but in a way that also shows we believe that we deserve it and that we can share it with others. So the Maverick Experience is not just mine, it's yours too. And when you go there, remember, you're not just helping me, you're helping other people in the process, because I donate 10% of all my commissions to Western Michigan University for the theater arts and dance program. And that is one of my ways of giving back in my level of abundance. I believe that I have enough to share. Okay, enough preaching for now. I'm going to get on to some music and tune out for a little while. We'll be back as we get closer to Michigan City.
Our intention. So here, let me say something about intentions. People will often say to me, well, you know, I didn't intend to hurt their feelings, or I didn't intend to hurt them. We've all heard that, right? And perhaps we've even said that. I didn't intend to hurt them, or I didn't intend to do that. But what's always manifesting is our intention. So, all right, you're telling me what you didn't intend. What did you intend? All right? I didn't intend to hurt them, but did you intend to love them? Well, I didn't intend to overlook them, but did you intend to include them? Do you see what I mean? We want to turn that around so we can use that to support ourselves. And so, because what's always manifesting is our intention. So what am I intending? So if what I'm intending is for my life here to be heaven on earth, and I believe that's what we must do, we must absolutely intend, if we're not consciously intending that our life will be heaven on earth, there's no way for that to become so. It's not just going to happen as a little sideline. Right? There's a line in A Course in Miracles that says that heaven is a decision that I must make.